Another session of IPMAT paper 2019. So we'll discuss few more questions out here to solve. So here I am a 6-time CAT 100 percentiler, so fairly good idea about the exams which are there. So training students for CAT, IPMAT, MBA and BBA entrance exam for 18 years. My YouTube channel is Patrick 100, where you'll get a lot of questions for various exams. So you can also refer to questions for a CAT exam and other exam, because the idea behind solving each questions are similar. So you can look at that, that'll help you. And the website is patrick100.com. So courses run as classroom, crash course, online videos and test series. Look at a website called prep.patrick100.com. So let's look at solving a few questions. Logs, okay, less than one. Normally when there is an inequality, I have a basic rule saying that if both the sides are equal, then that value should be there in the option. So I'll try to understand with substituting. Suppose I put one, as the easiest thing to substitute here in the options. Okay, I prefer substituting, that becomes easier to solve. So if I put 1 out here, you will get log of 2 upon 1. Okay, which is log 2 to the base 2 will be 1. So if you look at both the sides are equal, so 1 should be in the option. And if you look at it, B option, there is no 1. I can rule that out. Look, I understand that here 1, 1, and this is less than sign. So technically, it doesn't satisfy. Technically out here also x is a curved bracket, and curved bracket means 1 by 3 less than x less than 1. So 1 is not in the option, but less than 1 is there. So you can say that 1 should be there in the option. So all a, c and d has 1. Now let me substitute something easier, like 0, let's say, because in the d option there is a 0 out here, because between minus infinity and 1 you have 0. So if I put 0 out here, what do I get? Minus 1 upon 2, but log of negative is not defined, so not possible. So again, D option ruled out. So you're left with A and B option, two option. Now put one of the values, you know, this is between 1 by 3 and 1, this is between 0, 1 by 3 and 1 by 2. Put one of the values and check. For example, let me put, let's say half. Half is between 1 by 3 and 1. So I put half, what do I get? 3 into 0.5 minus 1 upon 2 minus 0.5. Which, if you look at it here, 1.5 minus 1 is 0.5 upon 1.5. Right, so this is log to the base 2, 1 by 3. Since 1 by 3 is less than 2, the value will be definitely less than 1, because log 2 to the base 2 is 1, and if it's less than 2, it becomes less than 1. So I know the A value satisfies, so automatically C value will not be possible, because half is there in A option but not in C option. So substitution makes sense. So first I substituted x equal to 1, then I substitute x equal to 0, and then I substitute x equal to 0.5, eliminating the options as and when it came to get the answer. Easier to solve, can be quick, and you can get the answer fast. The set of values x will satisfy the inequality. Technically, you should make out that 343 is 7 cube. If you know it, great. Or you can, 7 7 is 49, 49 7 is 343. So you can make out that this will be 0.7 the whole cube. So which means 2x square minus 3x plus 4, 3. But should be ideally more than 3, because power, right? Fraction. Because in a fraction, the more the power, the value becomes lesser. So for left hand to be lesser, the power has to be more. So we can say more than 3. Again, we look at the same part, inequality. I substitute the option and check out. So I substitute 1, let's say, it's the easiest thing to substitute. If I put 1, what do I get? 2 minus 3 plus 4. 3 and 3 equal. Since it's equal on both the sides, so 1 should be in the option. Then directly rule out B and C option. Same property as I used in the previous sum. So you can use similar properties in many sums, and that helps you to solve things faster. So since 1 is there, so 1 is there in both the options. Again, the same logic holds. Here it is between half and 1. Here is between half and minus infinity and 1 plus infinity. Both are different values. So take 1 and substitute. Take one of them value. For example, the easiest thing to substitute will be 0 out here. If I put 0, what do I get? 4, which is more than 3, satisfies. So since D option satisfies, 0 is not there in A, A will not satisfy. So answer will be D option. So 0 is the simplest thing to put. Put 0 and get the answer. Could also start with putting 0 directly. So if I put 0 directly, we'll get 0.7 raised to 4. And if you calculate, you'll see it is less than 0.343. The moment you put 0 and it satisfies, you can make out that A and B option rule out, because A and B option don't have 0. Even there, that is one way you can solve, satisfy. Then you can put larger value and check. Okay, now this looks tough, but it makes sense to draw in a geometric figure. A chord of drawn inside a circle is the length of the chord is equal to radius. So let's say radius and the length of chord. So all the three lengths are same, which means you can make out this is a equilateral triangle. Now two circles are drawn on each side of the chord, each touching the chord at its midpoint. So that means here it's a chord one touching the midpoint. Here it's a chord, another circle touching the midpoint circle and touching the circle. K be the ratio of the areas. Normally what I do out here, I just take an approximate figure and check out. So if I look at the radius of the bigger circle to the small circle, bigger circle much bigger than the small circle. It will be in a ratio of 4 is to 1, 5 is to 1 or bigger than that. The ratio of the radius, let's say 5 is to 1 approximately. So ratio of the area will be 25 is to 1. Your ratio of the radius is 5 to 1, ratio of the area will be 25 to 1. I think approximate. A and B option definitely ruled out. Now this one I got by the property saying that if the ratio of the side is A is to B, then ratio of the area will be A square is to B square. So that's how I get if ratio of the radius is 5 to 1, the ratio of the area will be 25 to 1. A and B option of too small to be the answer, not possible. C and D, one of them could be the answer. So I can check it out. There's no harm in checking out. But you can, if you go refined, you can make out that C also will not be possible. D will be the answer. But anyway, let's check out. So you can take the value. Okay. We know that the height in an equilateral triangle. Okay. Height is root 3 upon 2 times the side. So if the side is 2, let's say the height will be root 3. That's how it is an equilateral triangle. 30, 60, 90 angle. So which means if I take the radius as 2. Okay. Then this whole thing becomes 2 radius. But this height becomes root 3, which means the diameter of the smaller circle will be 2 minus root 3. That's the diameter of the smaller circle. I'm taking ratio of diameter. It doesn't matter if you take ratio of diameter. And diameter of the bigger circle will be 4 will be the diameter of the big circle minus the diameter of the smaller circle. Will give you the diameter of the middle circle. Okay, 4 is the diameter of a very large circle minus diameter of the smaller circle, which is 2. 2 is the radius minus root 3 is the height. 2 minus root 3. So 4 diameter minus 2 minus root 3, you will get 2 plus root 3. Now you want to find a ratio of the area. So ratio of the area will be square of the ratio of the diameters or ratio of the radius. The same property, side and area. So I can take 2 plus root 3 upon 2 minus root 3, the whole square. So if I solve this, you will get 7 plus 2 root 3. Right? 7 plus 4 root 3, sorry. Denominator will become 7 minus 4 root 3. Now just to remove the denominator, you can multiply and divide by 7 plus 4 root 3. Actually here itself you can make out that 7 plus 4 3 root 3 will not be the answer. You can still mark the D option. But anyway, if you multiply to remove the denominator, you will get denominator as A plus B into A minus B, which is A square minus B square. 49 minus 48 is 1. And numerator will be 7 plus 4 root 3 the whole square, which is 49 plus 8 root 3 plus 4 root 3 the whole square. 48. So you get 97 plus something, I think 56. I must have done something. Yeah, sorry, 56 is this. Because 2 into 7 for the 28, 56. 56 root 3. So you get 97 plus 56 root 3. You technically don't have to solve all this. I mean, it looks so tough, but technically, if you just take the value and figure out that this is very small and this is very large, you can directly eliminate A and B, and technically you can eliminate C also, because the radius is too huge. Out here also, when you come across to this particular value, you can make out the value has to be more than 7 plus 4 root 3. From there also, you can make out D option. Approximation helps. I mean, how to approximate, what to approximate is a very different technique, which will come later, but approximation helps. Okay, here 1 is to n, if you look at, I normally substitute values, as I said to you earlier. So let me put n equal to 1. I mean, hopefully you read a sum A, B, C, D. It makes sense to read a sum and first try to solve. And P, Q, R, S is somewhere in between. So P, Q, R, and S, let's say. Let's say that you want APPB. So APPB, if I take ratio 1 is to 1, okay, n is 1, then the area of the inside square becomes half the area of the outside square. Because this is 1, 1, root 2. So outside area is 4, inside area will be 2, the ratio is 2 is to 1. So when n is 1, my ratio has to be 1 is to 2. When n is 1, my ratio should be 1 is to 2. I hope you understood. This AB is 2, so the area will be 4 of the square. And PQ is root 2, so area will be root 2 square, which is 2. So ratio will be 2 is to 1 or 1 is to 2. So from the option, I can rule out B option. I can also rule out D option. So only left is A and C. Normally what I'll do is then I will start increasing. As in when I increase the value of 1 is to n, let's say 1 is to 4, 1 is to 5. Okay, I'm taking the other extreme value. Okay, if I take 1 is to 5, then the ratio of the areas will be almost equal to The ratio of the two areas will be almost equal. Let me put in the option. If I put in the A option, it becomes 1 is to 6. No, it should be equal. So A option also ruled out. If I put 1 is to 5, n is 5 here. You should get the ratio as almost equal for the two areas. Just draw and check out. But A option is 1 is to 6, not possible. So answer will be C option. Where if I put 1 is to 5, I'll get 1 plus 25 is to 1 plus 5 the whole square. Or 26 to 36. Possible. The areas are almost equal. I don't need to exactly solve it. As long as I eliminate three options, I get the answer. And that is what is important. The key in an examination is not necessarily to solve accurately. You don't have marks for your steps. You have to get the right answer, and that is what is important, which will only come maybe if you know how to approximate, how to figure out a value, and how to eliminate the option. These are very important techniques to, you know, crack an aptitude examination. Because unfortunately, a lot of people go with a traditional formula base and try to calculate accurately, which not only wastes a lot of time, but ensures that there are some mistake in the steps and you go wrong. So try to learn techniques and tricks that should help you be fast. Thank you.